Hello everyone, it's Michelle the Stamp Booker, and I am here today to join Desiree's tell with her celebratory hop of 1700 subscribers. And I'm so excited to join her. And in honor of her, I wanted to do something that she has inspired me to do. So it's not an actual scrap lift, but it is a Project Life spread. I think she'll be really excited to see this. I even took a 12 by 12 piece of paper and marked it off like one of the more common Project Life spreads. And then I actually took, she will also be proud of me because I am using all scraps. This is a kit. It's a paper cushion called I Heart Us from, I think it says 2018. And I love this collection because I really gravitate towards bright and happy colors. So I have some leftover Close My Heart Calls and Picture My Life cards, but they're Project Life. And I have a leftover 6x12 sticker sheet. I have another sticker sheet. I don't remember how it ended up with so much. I think it's because I taught a class. Because I also have two 6x12 chipboard sheets. And then this is back when Close My Heart was on the back side of a piece of paper, they had cut-aparts or cutouts. And so I have a little bit left of that. And then it's also back when they were still doing for makers, which are consultants, we could buy 6x6 samples of all the paper. And so I have also, it's not in like a smaller scale, but oops, let me turn this light on. But it is, there, that's better. It is still more paper for me to work with, right? And anyway, so I have all these scraps. This chipboard. Scrap. That's white. And then I do have one 12 by 12. This is a raspberry pink. And on the other side is like a ballerina with raspberry dots. And then I have some, mostly it's 3x4s, but I do have some 4x6s, and then I have some that are the wrong orientation. Well, that one will work. I guess they all will work. Yeah, because Close to My Heart has it one way on one side and one way on the other. Okay, so, and I actually printed out like a whole stack of photos from a trip. And I just went ahead and printed them out 4x6. I had them printed at Persnickety Prints. And I have like, let's see, a whole stack. Okay, this was to document a trip my husband and I took to Fredericksburg, Texas. I don't know if you've ever heard of it, but it's really pretty place in the Texas Hill Country, and it was to document our 20th wedding anniversary. So we actually also got married in Fredericksburg, so I wanted to make an album, and I'm one of those that second guesses everything. Like, I had them all printed 4x6 from Persnickety, and then I'm like, well, maybe it should be a smaller album. And I really think with all these 4x6s, it's going to be better to have it in a 12x12 format. So, I also overthink, like, does the whole album have to be the same collection? And I've decided that no, it does not. I'm going to start out with this collection. I have photos of restaurants we ate at the Airbnb we stayed at, some sightseeing we did. And so, I'm just going to switch it up. So, this is my thought process. This, I thought, could be a title card. Upper left, traditional project life, right? And then a 4x6 and another 4, but I thought this front page could be several of our selfies or pictures taken of us from the trip. It doesn't have, they're not from the first day, although this one is. Okay. Then I had a 4x6 of this, but I made it a 3x4 so that I could have photos here. Originally, I put 4 3x4s across here, and I didn't like that there was only a photo here and a photo here, and then maybe here. So I printed that in a 3x4 from home, and then I had this one that is a 4x6, and that one was really easy to make into a 3x4. So I made that there, and this one's gonna go here. And then I'm thinking you and me here, and maybe love you more here. I also have some other options. I have this one that's hearts. I have you're so wonderful to me. Was actually it's a cut out from that 12 by 12 sheet. And then this one doesn't go with it. It was a 4x6 I cut down. Motherhood is a love story with no ending. That will go with a different theme, right? Our bucket list, I don't believe. Don't know. It could be our bucket list of Fredericksburg. Today we. So that could work either way. This is a nice journaling. See, like this one will not work in my format. Hold on. Okay, but actually, I forgot that this could turn this way. So this one could actually go here. Here's another plain one. You are my person. You are my happy place. Then I have a couple other ones. These are just really fun colors. It's like the blue is bluebird, and I feel like it matches my husband's shirt really well. And I've actually documented him and me with this paper collection before, when we had a date night, and I'll try to remember to pull that layout so I can see it. And I think I've also used it for an Easter layout. Okay, so then just playing around, I'm thinking I could kind of go like that, or there's this, and I haven't decided if these are gonna go on the photos or the page protectors, but so there's more of these. I actually can go pretty far with this collection. So yeah, between the stickers and the chipboard, and then I can make embellishments. But I just wanted to show you what I'm doing and that I'm using scraps, and I'm super excited about this. I've never finished a trip before scrapbooking. I have never finished scrapbooking a trip, let me say that correctly. So anyway, I will come back with my completed layout, and I apologize for that glare right there. Very sorry about that. All right. Hey, I'm back. I fiddled around with it for quite a while, but I think it turned out well. I haven't put it in the page protectors, so you don't have the glare. I have not actually glued the little embellishments down. But I tried to make some visual triangles, and whoops, I think this heart is supposed to be on top of this heart. So like a visual triangle with heart, heart, heart. So that's sort of a triangle, right? It was really the triangle is over. I mean, this heart was over here, and I don't know. You tell me. Can you read that word? We is that good or is that not good? I put some clear shimmer trim on this card and then just put some little glitter pink gems on it. Here I just have two chipboards. I was trying to make a visual triangle kind of with the blues, although there's blue. You know what? It's okay, right? What I'm really most proud of is I really think this, the title card turned out really cute. And I use a combination of, these are Tim Holtz, tiny little, let me show you, tiny little metal dies. And then this is L Studio. And then these two are from Pink Fresh. And then I did stamping in a retired color called Thistle that's in this collection. And I'm so excited about this stamp. It's my first time to use it. It's called Prairie A1259. And it's brand new. I think it's available August 1st. And look at it. All lowercase. Can you see that okay? Here we go. Okay, y'all, I was writing a card yesterday and I could not write hello without a W on the end. I was starting to write W. Look, I wrote it like this, hello. And so then I go to correct it, I start adding a W again. So you know what I did? Since these are handmade cards, I cut it in half. And then I put the decorated front on another card. Okay, I'm telling on myself. I was watching Allie Edwards a little yesterday, and she inspired me to do this little half circle right here. She does a lot of half circles. And also, I decided to not try to make my stamping perfect. I'm trying to embrace that. It's kind of bothering me. This could easily be redone because it's at the bottom of the card. But, you know what? I think I like it that way. And if I decide I don't, I can cover this up with another strip of paper. And the only other thing I added was this little strip of striped paper, a quarter inch. I love rainbow paper. Isn't that gorgeous? And this, Bluebird. So I'm going to look in my new core catalog that stamp set is in, and also I'm going to see, because we're coming out with colored enamel dots instead of just white and black, and I want to see if Bluebird is one of the blues in the blue assortment. So they come in different light colors, so there'll be a blue and red and yellow and pink and green, etc. So, oh, and then here also, I was not going to use another photo. I was going to have it like here, photo card. But I wanted to say that this was in Fredericksburg, and this was a photo I took there at the visitor center. And I guess FBG is short for Fredericksburg. So I just cut it down a quarter inch on all sides and matted it in this mint. So I hope I did Desiree proud. I feel like I did good. So this is going to be the front page of my wedding album. Not wedding. Whoo! There's another album to do. This is my anniversary trip. So then I'll flip the page and I'll do the back side. And then probably I will alternate with pocket page and then a 12 by 12 spread. I also can slip in 8.5 by 11s, 6 by 8s, 6 by 6s. I can do flip flaps. I can add pocket plus pages, which are like, they're kind of like a pocket page, but maybe just half of one. So I have a lot of flexibility and I'm excited. I appreciate y'all watching, and I have to say that I would not get things done if I did not have deadlines and commitments, and I committed to helping celebrate, and I'm so glad I did, because this would still be not done, and now I'm super happy with it. It's just a happy it's just a happy page, and I love this collection. I wish I had, like, I don't know, a whole lot more of it, but I have bits and pieces, and with pocket pages, it's gonna go far. So I think I might make this, I might continue making these on my YouTube channel. Let me know if you're interested in following that, and let me know if you have any questions. And please, please check out all of the other people that are helping Desiree celebrate. And definitely go wish her congratulations on her big milestone. I'll talk to you later. Bye.